Another look at the vigil happening in Annapolis, Maryland tonight, remembering the five lives cut short in the newsroom at the Capital Gazette newspaper. Tonight, we know their names. Gerald Fishman was the editorial page editor. He'd been at the paper for more than 25 years. Robert Hiaasen was an assistant editor and Sunday columnist, affectionately known as Big Rob. John McNamara loved covering sports. A former editor says he could do it all, writing, editing, designing pages. Rebecca Smith was a sales assistant, 34 years old, engaged to be married. Wendy Winters was an editor, reporter, columnist, and active volunteer in the community. The editorial page of the Capital Gazette today is, in a word, striking. It reads in part, "Today we are speechless. This page is intentionally left blank to commemorate victims of Thursday's shooting at our office," and then lists their names. And among those names, again, Robert Hiaasen, whose wife, Maria Hiaasen, joins me right now. And Maria, I am so sorry for your loss. I cannot imagine how hard it must be for you right now. All I can tell you is that since last night, I've been reading about your husband, and he seems like he would be the best guy in the world to be friends with. Tell me about him.
Without a doubt, Rob Hiaasen was my best friend, and he was that for a handful of others. He and I like to say, you don't need a million friends, you just need really, really good ones. And he was always there for people, and a confidant when folks needed it, and someone ready with the wry little joke at just the right time. Typically, and ironically, a time like this when people were together hurting over something, and he understood the need that, you know, eventually you did need that break. And he liked to say, you know, it's a fine line between drama and comedy, tragedy and comedy, excuse me. Mm. And he knew when to give that line, and that actually wound up breaking the ice and making people feel more comfortable. He was a great best friend, if I can say that.
You can absolutely say that. Big Rob, I heard his brother calling him that this morning, and we see by this pictures,
yeah,
he was Big Rob.
Yeah, yeah, he was Big Rob. He was 6'5", and it's a nickname that actually came about when our children were in high school. They're in their 20s now. And a good friend named Zoe was over with the crew, and she dubbed him Big Rob, and it stuck. And it worked in his family, too, because his stature was much taller than that famous brother you mentioned, Carl, in that respect. He was always immensely proud of his brother, which is an interesting thing to address, because he, you know, he would encounter the occasional, oh, it must be tough to be Carl Hiaasen's younger brother. And it wasn't really.
Well,
he loved his brother and respected him.
Well, let me tell you, Carl was proud of Rob because of everything Rob had accomplished.
Yeah.
And I think the husband and brother that Rob was, and also the mentor to so many young people who wanted to be part of journalism. Tell me about that.
Yes, yes. And that's, you know, Rob was a natural observer and a natural human, in that he got humanity. He realized this big world is fouled up and is full of all kinds of mayhem and pressure. You can't be a journalist and not see that. But he understood that the key to success as a human being, and certainly the key to success as a journalist, is to remember your humanity, to remember people's feelings, to look for the human being behind the story. I'm sorry, I laughed. There was a time he and I both worked at the Palm Beach Post in West Palm Beach, and I was in the South County Bureau, he was in the main bureau, and he was covering the county commission. It was not a natural fit. Rich Gordon, his editor at the time, would definitely back me up on that. And he would call, Rob, what about the numbers? What about the tax rate? That's a great interview you had with the guy after. You
He'd
know,
be caring about the humanity.
The
and his editor was the numbers
the humanity,
on that.
Yeah. Then that's when we began, or he began, sorry, the journey to feature writing and the great love of narrative writing.
Talk to me. I understand I read today, and I need to hear it from your lips, that he was a big James Taylor fan, this big 6'5 guy, loved the sweet songs of James Taylor, and he got a chance to interview him.
I could go on.
And he was rendered nearly speechless.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. Now, I was not there then. I believe that he had moved to Raleigh, North Carolina, and was working at a station that was my competitor. So he was an acquaintance, maybe, I'd seen. But within a year's time, we were engaged and got married. That was very quick. So I do know the lore of this, the story of how he and a great friend, Bob Phillips, went to cover James Taylor. This was during the time when James Taylor was campaigning for Jim Hunt, running for the Senate seat Jesse Helms held at the time. And Rob loves him. I can't tell you how many times he saw him. I know it was approaching 20. We were there last summer in Philadelphia to see him. Let me interject that. With Bonnie Raitt, it was a fantastic show. And I'm more of a punk rock fan, so this is interesting, this marriage in that respect. But as Bob Phillips tells it, and Rob did as well, yeah, I got up there. I just didn't know what to say. I couldn't. I was speechless. And there was that humility and, again, a human being. I heard guests earlier talking about, you know, some journalists make mistakes. Let me be clear that all journalists do, all human beings do. It's those of us who are adults in the world, whether we are in elected office and sitting in the White House or elsewhere, those of us who are adults who admit mistakes and try to correct them, who are the adults in the room.
Maria
and my
Hiaasen.
Husband was an adult, and he was not a bad person, and he was a professional.
God, he was not a bad person
in my life
at all.
He was not. This is a loss to me, to my children, to my family extended, and to this community. This is huge.
It's a loss, I think, for all of us. Maria Hiaasen, thank you for joining us. Thank you for helping us remember the humanity, as you say your husband Rob would want us all to do.
Thank you.
Maria Hiaasen, we'll be right back.